Skype for Windows Desktop is packed full of features to help you share special moments. Let's take a quick tour to help you find your way around. Here on the left, you'll find a list of your contacts and conversations. Conversations with unread messages are highlighted with an orange dot. Select a conversation or contact to bring up your chat history with that person. Instant messages, emojis, emoticons, and more are all shown here. This is where you send stuff from. You can either type a message or click on the paperclip to show ways to send photos, files, video messages, or contact details. To get the full Skype experience, use these buttons to start a Skype audio or video call. You can also add someone to the conversation or change your language settings for Skype Translator. This area has a lot of useful features. You can return to Skype Home, open the dial pad to call landlines and mobiles, or start a new conversation. You can also search through your contacts or search the Skype directory to find new contacts. Last but not least is you. Your profile picture, display name, and Skype status are shown here. If you click on your display name, you'll see your profile on the right. This shows what people can see about you when they search for you on Skype. In the Skype help and support articles, we often mention the menu bar, which you'll find here. You can do a lot from the menu, so take a moment to explore the items there. One important thing which you'll find on the menu bar under Tools is the Options window. It's the place for you to set all kinds of preferences for how Skype works, including your privacy settings.